Howdy folks, and welcome back to Let's Play Faxanadu. And I guarantee you guys, at least at one point during this Let's Play, I'm gonna call this game Faxanadu, and people are gonna flip their shit. Cause that's what we called it when we were growing up. Much like Kid Icarus, we called it Kid Icarus. I'm sure it's coming. And even though we are still a novice, we did level up. Rank 0, which is like where you start, and rank 1 are both novice rank. There are 16 levels in this game. I honestly don't expect us to hit level cap unless I do grinding, which is probably likely. Get out of here, you damn roaming hit points. Do it. Okay, check something. All right, it does not give us like our, it doesn't show us hit points or anything. So I don't know like if leveling benefits you in any meaningful way. I'm sure it does. I'm sure that there have been studies done by people that tell you what leveling does. I can't remember if those things up top will bounce themselves off the ledges. I know you can force them off, but I don't know if they'll come after you. Okay, so the jumping in here is kind of deceptive. You can see that I can jump to the sides here, but if you're like, oh no, I guess not. I was gonna say, I could have sworn that these like overhangs, you'd catch on them. Apparently not. We are going to bump into a couple new enemies in here. Oh, they come down ladders. All right, so that's you guys' foul trick. Like I said, there are a couple new enemies in here. I want to say we're going to bump into, like, there's, like, these goat dudes. And I can't remember if we bump into our first enemy in here that uses ranged attacks. I don't think we will. Well, we will, but it's not going to be the enemy I'm thinking of because the boss has ranged attacks, but... Oh my god, the jumping in this game is really bad. Like, it is just really bad. Like, I totally should have made that, but I didn't. There we go. And there are some parts later in where I guarantee you guys, we eventually get wing boots that let you fly, but even those are, I think, limited use. It's just, there'll be rage. All right, yeah. These are the goat dudes, and you basically don't want to let them start flip jumping everywhere, which they do, as you can see. Little bastards. Yeah, I remember the trash that you guys get up to, and I think... Is the boss? No. Boss is coming up. I'm terrified, by the way. I remember the first boss in this game being incredibly nasty. Alright, those dudes are actually worth a decent bit of money. Is this the boss? No. All right. Yeah, those things are worth 100 gold apiece. That might be worth grinding. I don't know. Thankfully, items don't like disappear after a certain amount of time. Like they'll sit on the ground until you pick them up, as long as you don't leave the room. If you leave the room, everything resets. But oh my god, I am garbage. Also, I hope you guys like the color palette, because this is what it's going to be for the majority of the game. Alright, and these things are much like the goats, they just kind of jump around. Again, not too bad. Kill this guy. Come on. Also worth 100 gold pieces. Is this the boss? I know he's got to be like in this next room. I know he's around here somewhere. Get this thing with a deluge. I'm probably gonna blow through all of my magic on the boss if I had to guess. Ah! Yeah, this is the boss. Alright, so this is our first boss. Not too threatening, but we have to get up there to hit him. That's the problem. Oh. Or we can just spam death magic, which I am much more confident in my ability to do. Dude's got a lot of hit points, though. Okay, so we killed him. He was worth a substantial amount of money, and we are now holding the mattock, which will let us get through that blockage as I knee my desk, which isn't going to be nearly as loud as it used to be since I got my new microphone stand. So does this guy respawn? I can't remember. I think he does. Yeah, so, like, we could fight him again, which... I wonder if I, like, can I hit him from here? Oh, I think we're gonna kill him again. I could get down there and stab the shit out of him. Like, you can time your jumps to dodge those. I might have enough mana to just death magic him down one more time. Yeah, alright. I'm not gonna kill him again. I just wanted some extra blow money. And that dude was worth, like, what? 600 almost. Like, I'll take that. Now we just have to get out of here and not die. This is the tricky part right here. Overall, though, I'm pretty pleased with that we got through that with... Oh, and, like, okay, it cost us, like, what, 250 gold pieces, right? For the mana. And I guess our health, too. And then another 100 for the key. But beyond that, it's all profits. It's like the first kill, we like maybe broke even and gained a little bit. Because I mean, we actually probably broke even making our way up to him, just killing critters. Like, notably these goat suckers, which I need to not be treating as lightly as I am because they're actually quite dangerous. Oh no! Oh, we're gonna get hit here. Oh, of course you would. You would jump in the one area where it's like a huge pain in the ass. Anyways. So yeah, like, this is a pretty profitable little run here. Ah! Dwarf ambush! I wonder if I could... I don't think you can attack while you're on a ladder. We're not gonna be able to kill that thing. Like, the trick is getting back to town. And I'm honestly, the thing that worries me most is jumping over the little spiny dudes. Like, I'm pretty sure I can kill dwarves, I'm just gonna need to be careful. Oh! Sneaky dude! You bastard! Getting me from behind. Oh, this is bad. This room is gonna be bad. Because we gotta, like... Yeah, we gotta... Oh, I'm dead. Nope, nope, nope. And this is where I'm like, oh man, I want a fucking save state. So bad right now, but I can't. Oh, I'm... Yeah! We just died. I think you lose your XP or your gold when you die. I can't remember. Don't have negative thoughts. Remember your mantra. Oh, you lose it all when you die. And this is why you save. So we're going to go ahead and reload when you're back in town. Let's go do this again. And this time I'm actually, I think, gonna try to conserve my mana as best we can. I wanna try killing that dude 3 times. We'll need to see how much mana I have once we get there. I'm actually kind of tempted to grind out a potion. I think we're gonna do that. I'm gonna grind out a red potion. I wanna see how much they cost. I love the town music in this game. It is like the... This game, like, I actually really like the music in this game. It's not great, but I don't know. It's like a childhood thing. Let's see. Red potion is 300. All right, so we gotta kill 6 of the... 6 dwarves. I think I can do that. I mean, we could hike back to the first town, but I think that's probably a little more work than I'm willing to put in, just to save, what, 100 gold, maybe? Get that. Okay, 45. And we're just gonna jump back and forth between this. I'd throw magic, but again, I wanna save my mana. So, okay, you can note that... Like, we're killing the zombie dudes, and I think 2 hits now? We weren't doing that before, when we were only level 0. Although I might be double-hitting them, I think I'm just double-hitting them. But I do believe your, like, offensive powers and stuff go up as you gain levels. I know your hit points and mana pool do. Because, like, at this point, we could get the death spell, but I don't think we'd actually be able to cast it. There. Alright, so now we have enough money, let's go buy a potion. We'll save again, we'll tackle this thing, and we'll be fine. Our expenditures are going up a little bit, but if I can save my mana, damn it, if I can save my mana, the earnings will outstrip it. Give me that there red potion. And we are, of course, going to save again. Because, you know, cowardice. This is a game that is very much made a lot easier if you're abusing save states. Like, a lot of this game is resource management. Like, don't overextend yourself like what I did trying to get back here. Like, I shouldn't have killed that thing the second time. Then I would have been fine getting back to town. We would have had enough mana to fight, like, the little spiky dudes, and I would have been able to heal up or, you know, just kill these things with deluge spells. And so on. And believe me, it is really hard not to just, like, sit here and, like, I'm eyeing that save state button. Like, I want it bad. But we need to not. Oh, you freaking little bastards. I don't even know what those things are supposed to be. Little spiny critters. Okay. Come on. I don't remember how much healing potions heal for. I think they might heal you fully. So, like, I'm not worried as much about grabbing healing off of these little things. Which I want to say those are supposed to be loaves of bread that they're dropping, by the way. It's kind of hard to tell. They have, like, drawn pictures of... I'm fairly certain it's supposed to be a loaf of bread, and then the other things they just drop gold coins. But they have pictures in the manual of all of the gear that you can find, like your weapons and stuff, and like how they look on your character and in-game, because, I mean, you come in here and, like... Like, my hand dagger has a little sprite, my armor has a sprite, a small shield has a sprite. Well, this came out back before, like, you could just take screenshots of something on a console. So, like, all of the screenshots of, like, anything in-game, like, much like with old PC games, it's somebody sitting there with a camera taking a picture of it, so they just look like absolute crap. You can't hardly tell what the things are supposed to be. And it's just like, oh, it is beautiful. It is beautiful. I actually just bought this, like, a second copy. I had a copy, but, oh, man, there's a sad story. My little brother and I had a fairly large collection. I'm gonna kill this one with spells. We had a fairly large collection of Nintendo games, probably like 50 or 60 of them when we were younger. And then a GameSpot moved into town, and we ended up selling all of them. And made, like, you know, $30 for all of these, like, classic games. And, like, as the years have been going on, I've been just slowly rebuilding the collection. And this was, like, kind of an excuse, because, I mean, I only let's play games that I own, right? So, we're just gonna leave him back there. So, well, if I want to play Faxanadu, which I really do, I better buy a copy. And I was looking on eBay, and there was, like, a bare copy for $8, which is about what you'd expect to pay for a lesser-known Nintendo game. Most, like, more well-known, it's about $20, unless it's, like, some famous game or something. And then there was another one, which was $12, which is the base game with the manual, which is the one I ended up buying. There was also, like, a $35 or $40 one that came with the box. And anybody that collects Nintendo games knows that getting Nintendo games with boxes, depending on the game, is actually pretty hard, because a lot of people back then, they didn't save the materials. They just throw them out. All the boxes for these games ended up in landfills. And I was sorely tempted to buy that copy, but I didn't, because I know myself well enough to know that if I did, it would set a precedent, and I'd need to buy any Nintendo games that I bought from then on. I would need to buy the boxed copies if I could find them, and that is just asking for sadness. I'll do it with Nintendo game or PC games, like old DOS games and stuff, but Nintendo games, like, that's a dangerous game to be playing. Alright, so let's let this guy land, and we're just gonna nuke the crap out of him here. I think we probably have enough mana to kill him, like, 3 times, and if not 3, we have enough for 2. Yeah. 2 is gonna be no problem. We could at least do that. We could probably get a 3rd kill. I might have to melee him a little bit, but I think I'm gonna err on the side of caution and just conserve the mana to get us back to town. If I don't have to use this potion, I would rather not. Just because, like, if we're not using it now, we're gonna use it at some point. Come on, buddy. Come on. There you go. I was gonna say, you're, like, right there. We're actually nearing, I think, another level. Wrong button. Yeah, 2200. 3 away. We're not gonna do it, but we're almost there. I'm gonna deluge this guy, though. Because screw him. Okay, this would actually, like, I should have done this the last time we came through here. It's like, we can farm this little spiny dude, get some healing. I'm gonna get my health back up to about the midway point. Tentatively without dying to the spiny dude. I should probably kill this guy too, for fun and profit. Oh my god, dude. Hold still, and just, seriously? Come on! There you go. Yeah, ideally we'll have hit level 2. Each level in this has a different title. I want to say the highest title you can get is Lord, which is at the aforementioned level cap, 16. Oh yeah. We're gonna ding, I think, before we get down. Come on. I bet you this guy's... Are you carrying our level, buddy? Nope. That's gonna be one of the goats then, assuming I... Ooh, I elect to fight him. That little bastard's just gonna sit down there waiting. And there's our level. So now... We're still a novice. Oh. I might have to talk to somebody. Oh shit, no, we have to talk to the guru, I think, to rank up. I'm an idiot. Alright, we'll get our ranks then when we get back to town. Ah, get off of me. Okay, last goat dude, which is like our last real threat here. We'll probably be able to get back to town here, I would hope, without any need of healing. And any healing that I'm gonna get, I'm just gonna get by casting the deluge spell. Although I would actually rather hold on to the mana for that room that has two of these suckers in it, because them bouncing around just seems to, like, fuck my day up something fierce. As you guys can see, my incompetence knows no bounds. And we are coming back to town with 3,000 gold. Not bad. Okay, I'm gonna nuke this room. Just for the healing. There we go. Alright, we're good. Oh my god. Oh my god, we were good. And then I got the ever-loving crap kicked out of me there. Oh no, 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 no. None of that. Alright. Run away to healing! Give me your 250 gold piece special, buddy. 250 golds. Full health, full mana. Don't try too hard. Sure, buddy. Sure. Okay, so now... And save. We're gonna be saving again here momentarily, but... I shall give you a title! Battler! Make sure you live up to it! Alright, so that is our rank 2 title. Next level at 3,500. We're only 1,000 away, and we have more gold than we know what to spend it on. However... See, we're at 17 minutes. Yeah, I think we're gonna go ahead and call it here. So, as per usual, folks, thank you for watching. I hope you guys had a good time, and next time, we'll be knocking down a wall and getting our ass handed to us on the way to the next town, I'm certain. Until then...